every woman. Every woman achieving her goals in life. A woman of confidence and strength. A woman of honesty, beauty, and heart. A mother, a wife, a friend. Today, you will see women of differences and women of dreams. Miss Senior DC 2017.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Carly Jensen, Jr., Mr. C from the Time Tunnel, 96.3 WHUR. Thank you. Thank you. It is my pleasure emotionally to be here once again and to see our theme for this afternoon, Every Woman, with the help of the music from one of my favorite vocalists, Chaka Khan. Everybody say Chaka Khan. It's my pleasure to be here, and I tell you, we're gonna have a great time. And remember, encouragement is applause and smiles and making these ladies up here feel real good. Are you with me? Yeah. All right, at this time, I'd like to bring to the stage the executive director of the DC Office on Aging, my good friend, Laura Newman. Laura was, let's give her a round of applause. Here she comes. As you know, Laura, my good friend, was appointed by Muriel Bowser, our wonderful mayor, to lead the agency that provides programming services for residents aged 60 years of age, like me, and older.
And that can't adults, possibly be true, Mr.
Oh, yes, it is. And adults, of course, with special needs and their caregivers. I had the pleasure of working with her, and I love it. She's a wonderful person. She's a great advocate for the residents that she serves. Please welcome my good friend, Laura Newland. Laura?
Hi, everyone. Good afternoon. It's my pleasure today to bring some greetings and to say thank you to our partners. First of all, I want to say thank you to UDC. UDC hosts this event for us every year, and they're such great hosts and partners with us. So we couldn't do this event without UDC, so thank you guys. And the DC Senior Cameo Club, can we put the lights on the audience for a second so we can see? No? Okay. Well, it's like all dark, so I can't see anybody. But there's Cameo Club scattered in there. Okay, Cameo Club, now's your time. Thank you, Cameo Club, for helping us and for being a part of this rich history. You really have set the bar every year for all the contestants, and so we're really thrilled that you're here and continue to participate with us. Of course, our 2017 Miss Senior DC, Frances Curtis Johnson, who you saw just a few minutes ago, thank you so much for representing the District of Columbia so well over the past year. She is leaving some pretty big shoes to fill. And then I am really pleased to say that the reigning Miss Senior America, Carolyn Slade Harden, is here. So thank you so much for being here and joining us in the festivities today. So this year's theme is Every Woman. And the theme, Every Woman, really represents everyone, everything that these women have done. They have been great mothers. They have been great businesswomen. They have challenged the status quo. And that's what I think of when I think of these women, because these women have really opened the door for all of us to say, no matter who you are, you can be that person, and let's concentrate on living well and being proud of our community. And I really, when I think about why I choose to make DC my home, these women are the reason why. So put your hands together. You're going to have a great show today. And these women are just going to wow you. And so just relax, enjoy the show. And I'm going to introduce to you one of my favorite women. I'm not saying that just because she's my boss, I promise. Okay? She's the Deputy Mayor for Health and Human Services, Hai Suk Chung. And I got to say that she has been such a great partner to us at the DC Office on Aging. Because when I say things like, Deputy Mayor, aging is living, she's like all about it. When I say, Deputy Mayor, we gotta talk about aging as if it's a great positive thing. Let's celebrate living, because that's what the DC Office on Aging really does. And so today she has a special treat for us. I know a lot of you spend a lot of time trying to figure out what you're gonna wear, and I know our queen spent a lot of time trying to figure out what we're gonna wear, but today she pulled out a special hat. Yes, and so I'm so glad she took it seriously. She's been talking about it for months, so I'm pleased to introduce to you the Deputy Mayor, Hai Suk Chung.
Thank you so much. Yeah, sure.
Good afternoon, and the light is so bright. I take seriously when the Cameo Club members actually charged me for being glamorous on a day like this, and so I had to go get the right wardrobe. So again, thank you for acknowledging my incredible hat. I am the Deputy Mayor for Health and Human Services, and I have the privilege of working with not only the director, but the entire agency at DCOA. So I want to acknowledge all of the staff that are here that put this event together, especially Darlene. I have no idea where you are, but I know you're here somewhere, and I want to just thank you for your hard and incredible work to put this together. I also want to acknowledge the director. Oh my goodness, I can't fathom DCOA without Director Newland, who charges all of us to think about all the ways that we can be creative to support our seniors to not only live in place, but live gracefully and so happily here in this city. And so I'm really privileged to work with her day in and day out. I also want to echo our support and really love affair with Mr. C. Thank you so much for being here and being our MC. And on behalf of the mayor, I want to congratulate the 8 contestants here today. We are going to see some incredibly strong women, and they're not only showing us how wonderful it is to age, but how wonderful and glamorous it is to just be a contestant on this beautiful pageant. I want to acknowledge and thank our judges, and last but not least, I want to just thank our reigning Miss DC, Senior DC. Where's Francis? I have no idea where you are. Where's Francis? In the rear. Thank you so much for leading this last year with such grace and poise and representing DC all over the country and the world. Your just an incredible enthusiasm for not only this pageant, but for the District of Columbia and for all our senior Cameo Club members. I just cannot imagine you not being part of the fabric of this incredible network of women and senior women who are reining us in to make sure that we live glamorously. So thank you again. Have a fantastic time. And again, on behalf of the mayor, who unfortunately could not be here, she's a little jealous that I got to dress up and be here with all of you today. So I will send pictures to her, and I know that she is really looking forward to meeting all the contestants today and the winner of today's pageant. So again, have a fantastic time.
So now I'd like to bring to the stage our very own host from WFRJ 68.5 FM, Miss Senior DC, Frances Curtis Johnson. Let's give her a round of applause.
Good morning to you. I'm your host, Lady J, coming to you live from wherever you are. 67.5 FM on your radio station, the station where seniors rock and rule the world. Want to know what's on your mind today? Caller number one, you're on the line. Hello? Hello? Can't you hear me? Can't you hear me? This is Andrea, and I'm calling because I want to talk about the immigrant situation. I am American, and I was born and raised here in America. And my father served in the military forces here. And I just want people to know that because I may not talk like you or look like you, I am American. I love this country, and it is my home. Andrea, thank you so much for calling in, and we love you too as an American, and we say stay strong, stay American, we love America. Thanks for calling in. Caller number two, you're on the line. What happened, B? How you doing? You hear me, Lady J? How you doing? Just want you to know, I just celebrated my 82nd birthday, and I'm going to celebrate it just like I was 28 years old. And you know what I'm going to do for my birthday? I'm going down to them clubs on 14th and U, and I'm gonna have myself a good time. I'm gonna show them little young folks that twerk and gyrate how you do the atomic dog. I'm gonna get it on. You know what I mean, Lady J? Only problem is, my husband, he don't wanna go. So I was wondering, you think you could babysit my husband till I get my groove on? I really got to go now, cause he hungry. But I'm gonna hit you back, okay? Bye, love your show. Well, Miss B, I wanna wish you a happy 82nd, 28th birthday. You have a good time at the club now. I can't babysit your husband, but I want you to get your Philly atomic dog on for me. Thanks for calling in. Well, that's all the time we have now. Keep your station on 67.5, the station where seniors rock and rule the world, WFRJ. Thanks for tuning in, and we're gonna take it out DC style with Brother Chuck Brown. Let's take it off.
I think my job's in jeopardy. All right, let's give another hand to our reigning queen, Miss Senior DC Frances Curtis Johnson. Wow. I see why she did good last year, you know? Yeah. Now we bring to the stage our previous pageant winners, our ladies of elegance, and I proudly say that, who have represented the District of Columbia in the Miss Senior America pageant across the city. Ladies and gentlemen, our ladies of royalty. Thelma Morgan, 1999. Miss Daisy Savage, 2002. Daisy got her own fan club in here. My good friend, Sandra Beers, 2005. From 2006, Miss Ann Thomas, 2006. And from 2007, Lucille Watkins. Don't they look lovely? From 2009, Shirley Riven Smith. She always keeps me straight in the back, so let's give her a round of applause, come on. From 2010, Sheila Poole, 2010. And bringing up the next year is 2011, Miss Emma Ward, Miss Ward. Is Mary McCoy. 2014. Please give a round of applause for Tony Jackson. And another good friend from 2015, Miss Wendy Bridges. And finally, from 2016, Billy Laverne Smith. Let's give them a round of applause. From 1998, Miss Elaine Terry. We neglected her, but please welcome her. Come on, you can do better than that. Let's give these ladies a round of applause. You know something, ladies, ladies and gentlemen, each year this gets more and more exciting. Come on, give them a round of applause, please. Every woman. What an appropriate selection for this year. Okay, let's get started. Our first contestant is Hadia Muhammad. Hadia will combine movement and modeling as she shows off her cultural attire to the music of Michael Jackson, Liberian Girl. Contestant number one, Hadia Muhammad. Contestant number two, here we go. Contestant number two is Phyllis M. Jordan. She is going to portray something from Nina Simone, and we're very happy to have her here with us today, and I have a script that she's given me, written by Nina Simone. It's called Four Women in the Late 1960s. Nina said she wrote the song after having numerous conversations with black women. For American, African-American women. It became an anthem affirming the struggles to survive. And you ladies know what I'm talking about. Nina electrified us with her storytelling, continues to influence artists even today, the great Nina Simone. There are plays and works named in honor of this song, Four Women. It is a suitable reminder that your name is not what it is. I give you Phyllis M. Jordan.
Black, my skin is black, my arms are long, my hair is woolly, yeah. My back is strong, strong enough to take the pain inflicted again and again. What do they call me? They call me Aunt Sarah. I'm older now. My skin is yellow. My hair is long. Between two worlds, I do belong. My father's rich and white. He forced my mother late one night. What do they call me? They call me Sophronia, Sophronia. My skin is tan. My hair is fine. It's all right. My hips invite you, Daddy. My mouth's like wine. But whose little girl am I? Anyone with money to buy? What do they call me? They call me Sweet Thing. Sweet Thing. My skin is brown. My manner, it's tough. And I'll hurt the first person I see because my life has been rough. And I'm awfully bitter these days. You see, my parents were slaves. What do they call me? What do they call me? My name is Peaches.
Wow. I told you, uniqueness. Thank you, Ms. Phyllis Jordan. Contestant number three is Jocelyn Thompson. Ms. Thompson. And she's on her way to a Caribbean Day parade. She'll be dancing, but let her tell you a little bit more about what she's doing. I give you Jocelyn Thompson.
I don't want these young people to know I'm going to DC Carnival on Georgia Avenue. They say I'm too old to be jumping behind the band, plus I got bad knees. But bad knees never kept me back before, and I'm not old. I'm 77 years young, aging, not aged. So seniors, come with me. Come, let's go to the carnival. Are you ready?
Jocelyn Thompson. I told you this year is going to be very, very special. How you like them moves, huh? Okay, contestant number four is Paulette Cunningham. We're going to slow down the pace just a wee bit and introduce to you the new up-and-coming Miss Maya Angelou, okay? This young lady has been writing poetry for several years for parties, nursing homes, and churches and the like, and other celebrations, and of course, special occasions. Sit back and listen to the words, and of course, the delivery of this poem called Life. Contestant number four, Paulette Cunningham.
These are the times that try men's souls. It does not matter whether you're young or whether you're old. We just can't seem to get or understand the real true meaning of life. Having to put up with so much hardship, bitterness, and strife. So we run and sometimes hide our feelings of emptiness so deep down inside, pretending that we just don't know why. We hold on to what we should not call pride, worrying about what others may say that makes us cry. When unfamiliar choices and paths come our way, many, many thoughts of confusion leads us astray, causing our mind to lose its direction and our footsteps along the way. We are blinded to tomorrow's joys and laughter because it's the worldly possession and material things we are after. But hope and prayer should always be on our minds. After all, it is the answer to these troubled times. With much hurt, pain, and scars, just a little faith in a higher power, we can change within and let the world know who we are. Life, don't take it for granted, nor throw it away, but look deep within your heart. You just might find your way. Life.
For that courage, let's give another round of applause. Man, you know, life is so good, we have to make exceptions sometime, am I right? You know, we got to treat people in the right way, talk to people in the right way, and do things in the right way, am I right? All right. Contestant number five is Patricia Sanker. Patricia has what they call an energetic way of working out. And this afternoon, she'll be working out with Jazzy Sticks to one of my favorite songs from yesteryear, a throwback that I don't get to play very often, but it was great, Jackie Wilson's Baby Workout. I give you Patricia Sanker.
Hey, you! Come on here on the floor. Rock some more. Come out of here on the floor. Honey, let's rock some more, yeah. Now when you get out here, don't you have no fear. Put your hands on your hip and let your backbone slip and work out.
Double
to the left.
Third.
Wobble to the right.
That was a workout. Another round of applause for contestant number 5, Patricia Sanker. Juanita Patterson is our next contestant. Now, she will sing a very popular love song recorded by my girl, Regina Bell, from the album Passion. Today, she'll sing it her way, if I could. Contestant number 6, I give you Juanita Patterson.
If I could, I'd protect you from the sadness in your eyes, give you courage in a world of compromise. Yes, I would if I could. I would teach you all the things I learned and help you cross the bridges that I burned. Yes, I would. In a time and place where you don't want to be, you don't have to walk this road. My yesterday won't have to be. If I could, I'd help you walk the
And she could. Round of applause for contestant number 6, Juanita Patterson. You enjoying yourselves thus far, huh? All right, keep that applause going. Contestant number 7 is Ruby Bourne. She has a very special and what we call an unusual talent. She is a collector, hopefully not a bill collector. She has a uniqueness about her. Ms. Bourne has been collecting for many years. So without further ado, let's hear from contestant number 7, Ms. Ruby Bourne.
I am Ruby Bourne. I am a collector of unique necklaces, watches, bracelets, scarves, and yes, fashion. I am Ruby Bourne. I am a coordinator of all my accessories and fashion by color, style, shapes, and appearances. I am Ruby Bourne. I am an organizer of all my accessories and fashion. Everything must be methodically and meticulously organized. I am Ruby born, and even though I walk with a cane, I have two hip replacements. I have on tennis shoes. This does not deter my ability. To be the best and the excellent, most excellent fashion coordinator that I can be. God bless you and thank you.
Thank you so much, Miss Ruby. We appreciate you. Let's give her another round of applause as well. You know, I told you when we started this evening, or this afternoon, that this was going to be a very unique presentation, and we're getting just that. All of these ladies have worked very hard at what they do, and we're so, so happy for all of them. Today, judges, is going to be kind of tough. It's going to be kind of tough, but I know you're going to do a good job. And some people out there say you better. Okay, once again, we turn to contestant number 8. This is Margaret Carter. Can we please turn the heat down? Can we please turn the heat down? Miss Carter will turn it up just a little with her dance to the music of Patti Lee. So ladies, hold on to your wigs. Children, hold on to your seats. Fellas, never mind. I give you Miss Margaret Carter dancing to Fever.
Never know how much I love you. Never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever. In the morning, a fever all through the night. Sun lights up the daytime, moon lights up the night. I light up when you call my name, and you know I'm going treat you right. You give me fever when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight, fever in the morning, fever all through the night. Everybody's got the fever, that is something you all know. Fever isn't such a new thing, fever started long ago. Romeo loved Juliet, Juliet she felt the same. When he put his arms around her, he said, Julie, baby, you're my flame. Now give us fever. When we kiss it, fever with our flaming youth. Fever, I'm a fire. Fever, yea, I burn forsooth. Captain Smith and Pocahontas had a very mad affair. When her daddy tried to kill him, she said, Daddy, oh, don't you dare. Give me fever with his kisses, fever when he holds me tight. Fever, I'm his missus.
At this time, I'd like to welcome the president of the DC Seniors Cameo Club, one of the presenters of this pageant, Ms. Vernell C. Hammett. Please welcome her.
Your support makes our pageant better each year. Thank you for your participation, because without you carrying our message, we would not continue to grow. The District of Columbia has been electing a Miss Senior DC each year since 1980. Originally, each ward had a contest, and their winners ran against each other. And then Miss Senior DC was selected. When Doris Thomas was elected queen in 1992, she felt we needed to be more organized. Family Matters and the Office of Aging were sponsors at that time. Now we are sponsored by the Office of Aging. Doris Thomas had the idea to form a club of all women who ran in the pageant each year. The Cameo Club was formed officially 23 years ago with just 6 elegant ladies. But each year we grew. We now have over 40 active members. Sadly, I have to let you know that our founder, Doris Thomas, passed in September of 2017. We also lost a lovely human being, Alethea Smith. She was a contestant in last year's pageant. If some of you were here at that time, you remember the young lady who played the saxophone. As a group of active women 60 and older, we use our extra time volunteering at churches, senior centers, hospitals, nursing homes, and at other venues when requests are made for seniors to perform. I hope you have enjoyed the program thus far. So sit back, find your happy place, and get ready to see the rest of our fabulous program. Thank you, and God bless.
Once again, thank you. We have a very kind of special treat for you today. We're glad to welcome Miss Senior DC Pageant to the stage, Miss Senior America Carolyn Slade Harden. Miss Senior America represented the Garden State of New Jersey during the Miss Senior America pageant. Let's give her a big District of Columbia welcome, Miss Senior America Carolyn Slade Harden.
Good evening, everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful time. I certainly am. I'm enjoying this. Okay. I'd like to say a few words about my reign as Miss Senior America. Growing old is inevitable, but aging is optional. Over the past year as Miss Senior America, scores of people have lifted me and allowed me to stand on their shoulders so that I could have a platform to encourage others. Without their support, I could not have become the role model I need to be for so many. And from this perch on the shoulders of others is how I will continue to step forward as Miss Senior America. Someone once said that we are who we are because of the hard work of the people who came before us. And it is my aspiration to exemplify the importance of standing on the shoulders of those who came before us, our founder, Dr. Al Mott, our directors, administrators, mentors, former queens, cameo sisters, volunteers, friends, family, and the good grace of God, so that those who follow us, our children, grandchildren, and those young girls who we once were, may stand on our shoulders and hold their heads high. I want to be the symbol of the mystical and mythical Sankofa bird, whose feet are firmly planted forward with its head turned back, meaning they carry the past into the future, or as symbolized by the Akan tribe in Ghana, learning from the past to ensure a strong future. In everything we do, we must keep our goals at the forefront. And my goal is to promote the well-being of my peers and our youth. I feel that if I put these goals at the core of what I do, good things will follow, like seniors who will feel empowered to pursue their passions, and youth that will understand and appreciate seniors as the foundation of our communities. Throughout this year, I have been able to promote my platform, Engage at Every Age, which means staying involved no matter how old you are and pursuing your passion, never giving up and being able to change challenges into opportunities. I have been unbelievably inspired by the number of seniors I have seen take charge of their lives and begin new journeys on a road to active and fulfilling lifestyles. It is said that every good and perfect gift comes from above, and being honored as Miss Senior America is absolutely one of those gifts. I am thankful to have been a part of something much bigger than myself. I have become so inspired by the people that I've met along my journey, and especially by my sisters here in DC. And to all the DC contestants, I pray that you approach this week not as a competition, but as an opportunity to meet someone different from yourself and encourage each other to become and overcome the insecurities we all share. My hope is that you take this experience with joy and love, and then you will walk away with much more than just a crown. It is the new Miss to the new Miss Washington, DC Senior America. Enjoy every moment because your year will go quickly. It is your job to be a role model because you are now part of something much greater than yourself. And now you will stand on our shoulders and we will be there to help you every step of the way. Thank you all so much for your warm welcome, the welcome I've received here in DC, and I am truly grateful to be a part of this sisterhood. Thank you. Now I'd like to share with you how much I love being here with you. I love the East, I love the West, the North and South, they're both the best. I'd rather be here as your guest, 'cause I love being here with you. I love the sea, the Jersey Shore. I love the rocks, and what is more, with you there, there'd never be a bore, 'cause I love being here with you. Singing in the shower, laughing by the hour, life is such a breezy game. Weather, as long as we're together, I love to hear you say my name. I love good wine, fine cuisine, and Darlene's touch, it's just supreme. And you make me feel just like a queen, and I love being here with you. Because there's something else you know. They know how to play it. They know just how to say it. They wind it up and let it go. I like the clothes that Anne wears. And Fran Johnson, I love her hair. But I'd like to say it's only fair that I love being here with you. And Mr. C. His utter charm takes me away. But don't get me wrong, how do you say that I love being here with you? I love the thrill of DC shows. I love my sisters, the cameos. And I'd like to say before I close that
that I love being here with you. All my girls are swinging, I like Tony singing, because there's something else you know. They know how to play it, they know just how to say it. They wind it up and let it go. If you love me and I love you, you love my sisters, we love you too. And I'd like to say before I'm through that I love, yes, I love being here with you. With you, you and you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you so much for that performance. You know, it was so wonderful and it was so personalized that I think we're going to have to forgive you for being from New Jersey. Don't you think? It's actually my pleasure to give you this small token of our appreciation for coming down all the way from New Jersey and joining us today. So thank you so much.
Someone told me my name was mentioned in that song. Now comes the fun part. I think this is kind of, you know, on the eloquent side, everybody's doing their thing and just looking very pretty. All the ladies look great. So we're gonna take our move to the next segment, our next and final segment of our competition, is the evening gown competition and philosophy of life. This should be very interesting, of course. The contestants will be judged on their poise, their elegance as they grace the stage. So let's welcome them energetically. Our first contestant is Hadia Muhammad.
Only once in a lifetime you meet that very special someone who touches your heart in so many ways. That very special someone who have achieved so many things in life. Wow, it's magical for me to finally realize that I am a phenomenal woman. I am.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Hadia Muhammad is a native Washingtonian. Her special interests include arts and crafts, taekwondo, boxing, cooking. Her escort today is her son, Daryl Robinson. Let's give a round of applause. Our next contestant is Phyllis Jordan, contestant number two.
The one factor that has affected my life and my relationships is the ability to communicate. I have trained myself to think before speaking by asking one simple question: what is my goal before I speak? If I had one gift to give you today, it would be the ability to communicate through the clarity of your goal. That one simple gift has the power to change your life.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Phyllis Jordan is from Clinton, Oklahoma. Her special interests including aiding D.C.'s homeless children and supporting Christ of Calvary offerings of HIV Project in Uganda, Africa. Her escort is her fiancé, Dan Tanzi. Give him a round of applause. Ladies are beautiful, I tell you. Our next contestant is contestant number three, of course. Joycelyn Thompson is originally from South America. Her special interests including dancing, traveling, water aerobics, and let's see what else she does, socializing with friends and solving some kind of puzzle. Quite interesting. Her escort today is her granddaughter, Rachel Thompson, a member of the DC National Guard. Please welcome her.
Principled defines your character. It means having integrity, compassion, being believable, being fair and respectful to all, and most importantly, being persistent and committed to your beliefs. I am a woman of principle. I am a woman of commitment. I try to follow through on promises that I've made and leave no stone unturned. Friends tell me I can't save the world, maybe not. I'm just trying to make a difference. A woman of principle.
I'd like to acknowledge your granddaughter for all the service. Let's give it to her, too. Rachel Thompson. God bless you. All right, let's turn now to contestant number four, Paulette Cunningham. Paulette Cunningham.
To love is to give. Give from your heart. Always be grateful for everything. Love yourself, love deeply, love unconditional. Be kind, be wise, be understanding, be positive, be creative, laugh out loud, be bold, live in the moment, never judge, know who you are and know where you're going.
Cunningham is a native Washingtonian. Her special interests include reading, writing, and reciting poetry, as she does so well, reading biographies, painting, tap dancing, and word games. She's escorted by a family member. Please give her another round of applause. Once again, thank you for your patience, your applause. You've just been a wonderful audience. God bless you. Thank you so very much. Contestant number five would be Patricia Sanker. Please welcome her to the stage.
I believe one should follow their dreams, their passions. Regardless of your age, regardless of what people may say or think, throw caution to the wind. Don't allow the past to dictate or hinder your future. Forge ahead, trust God, and do good, and live life to the fullest.
Patricia Sanker's hometown is Washington, D.C. She's a homegirl. or special interests are reading, tutoring children, and writing, reading, and basic math. We need that. She also enjoyed traveling, attending conferences, and of course, writing poetry. Her escort today is Ron White. Once again, thank you for your patience. We turn now to contestant number 6. I bring to you Juanita Patterson.
Outside my window, a new day I see. I decide what kind of day it will be. It can be busy, laughing, joyful, and gay, or boring, cold, unhappy, and gray. My state of mind is the determining key, for I'm only the lady I let myself be. I can enjoy what I do and have fun, or write, complain, make it hard on someone. But believe what I say, I intend to make the best of every God's given day.
Again, Juanita Patterson is a native Washingtonian. Her special interests include water aerobics, reading, yoga, traveling, singing, and meeting new people and sharing worldviews on peace and compassion. And that shows. Her escort today is Lyndon Augustine. Thank you, Juanita Patterson. Ladies are so professional, man. I'm so proud of the great job there. Let's give them another round of applause. This is just fantastic. Each year, this contest gets better and better, organized and very professional, and it's a blessing just to be here with you. Our next contestant is contestant number 7, Ruby Bourne.
Always put God first in your life. Keep a positive attitude. Never say you can't because you won't. Keep dreaming about what you want to do. Always be willing to listen, but slow to speak. Always have an open mind about what you want to do. And never be afraid to try new things.
Ruby Bourne is from Jackson, Mississippi. Her special interests including collecting scarves, watches, necklaces, and bracelets, to match her outfits. She also enjoys matching and putting on makeup and looking beautiful, and she's got to have the nail polish to get that complete look. Her escort is James Thompson of Terrific Incorporated. I give you Ruby Bourne. Shoes. That's what I'm talking about. This contest, I tell you, man, it's Contestant number 8, Mary Ann Carter. Please welcome her to the stage.
Child, I used to talk to God all the time. I used to ask him things like, why am I here? And what is the purpose for my life? I found out many years later that I was in the body of helps. So I try to help as many people as I can. When I see someone in need of help, I look at the end of my right arm and extend a helping hand. And if I'm in need of help, I look at the end of my left arm and help myself. Take a moment and look at your neighbors on your left and your right, and give them a helping hand.
Ladies and gentlemen, I incorrectly identified her as Mary Ann. It's Margaret Ann Carter. Margaret Ann Carter. She's a native Washingtonian. Margaret is very interested in the quality of life right here in the District of Columbia for our children and for their education. She's also very concerned about gun violence and sex abuse in the school system. Margaret Ann Carter. Well, ladies and gentlemen, with your applause and your acknowledgments, these ladies have demonstrated pure elegance. Don't you think so? So let's give our contestants another round of applause. Come on, you can do better than that. And this completes our judging portion of the contest. Now, I'd like to bring forward Miss Senior DC Frances Curtis Johnson to do her final walk in a farewell address. I present to you very proudly, Miss Senior DC Frances Curtis Johnson.
Good afternoon. You like my hair? Miss Senior America likes my hair. I am honored to be here before you as Miss Senior District of Columbia 2017. I wear the crown with pride and dignity, and I'll take my last walk on this stage. But I am more confident that the new queen will take the role and advocate for seniors throughout the city and serve the nation's capital. I'd like to thank Mayor Muriel Bowser and her esteemed cabinet members, Hai-Suk Chung, Deputy Mayor of Health and Human Services, Laura Newland, Executive Director for DC Office of Aging, and their tireless effort in advocating for seniors throughout this city. We're seniors, great. I thank everyone also that diligently works from day to day to bring on this pageant year after year, especially my coaching mentor, the versatile Ms. Jessica Franklin, who happened to be first runner-up in the Miss Senior DC Pageant 2016. And also, my predecessor, Miss Senior District of Columbia 2016, Billy Laverne Smith. And her coaching spirit and her high energy was very, very meaningful. I'd also like to thank all of the District of Columbia former queens 30 plus that preceded me and made my journey very, very easy. To my class of 2017, with an honor, I take privilege in knowing them and sharing the stage with them, a group of highly energetic, dynamic, and dedicated seniors. My court, Dr. Judy Ann Andrews, who was first runner-up, and Patricia Raglan, second runner-up, and Hadia Mohammed, Miss Congeniality, all dynamic, wonderful, strong women. With fond memories, I will always remember the sound of the saxophone making a joyful noise as she practiced and played on the stage. One of our contestants in 2017, Ms. Elinthia Smith, who went on to be with the Lord in April of this year. We truly miss her, and she will never be forgotten. It takes courage and a strong desire to achieve and to walk this master stage with a group of talented women. Only one will walk away with the crown, but we all stand together in the newness of friendship and graceful as we enter into our golden age. The reign of Miss Senior DC is to exemplify dignity, maturity, and inner beauty for all seniors who are our prized treasures. This competition will determine the woman most capable to serve and advance our seniors and advocate everything that they need. Okay, I know that the issues do not change, but seniors, we know what we want and what we are in need of. So I must say, I know and I thank the Bowser administration for continuing the efforts of the age-friendly DC strategic plan that she implemented in 2012. During my course, I must say my most interesting event was the Centennial Breakfast, where I met over 49 seniors, 100 years of age plus. They were energetic, spirited, youthful, full mind, and they had a lot to share. What a book. So that was most rewarding. Seniorhood rocks. Now, I must say that I also need to give thanks to my family who gave me the greatest support. They were there to encourage me. And I must say a major salute to my husband of 41 years who stood by me, encouraged me, moved me on, my Mr. PR, my love. Again, we thank the Bowser administration, the DC Office on Aging for their support, compassion, and love for the aging population here in the District of Columbia. And then I want to give my sincere thanks boldly going out to Darling Nolan, the DC pageant director, and the senior women of the DC Cameo Club for their A-plus touch of class, dedication, compassion, and support for the seniors and the young people of this great city. And in closing, I want to thank my Lord and Savior for the endurance to represent the District of Columbia, especially the seniors, as your queen, Miss Senior District of Columbia 2017.
Ladies and gentlemen, the senior DC, Frances Curtis Johnson, doing her last walk. Let's give her a round of applause. Represented you guys very, very well. Let's give another round of applause. And now, it's my pleasure to bring the lady to the stage who kind of keeps me straight back here. And sometimes that's a little difficult. But she is the DC State Pageant Director, my good friend, and I underline the word good, Darlene Nolan, for a presentation. Darlene is Community Relations Specialist with the DC Office on Aging. Please welcome her.
I'm going to take this moment to bring Ms. Frances Curtis Johnson back out, please. I just love this lady. Ms. Frances Curtis Johnson, Miss Senior District of Columbia 2017, pageant theme, The Greatest. Everybody was here for that, right? Thank you for serving as our gracious ambassador. June 24th, 2018, Darlene Nolan, District of Columbia State Pageant Director, District of Columbia Office on Aging. We present this to you. She has been an amazing Miss Senior DC. She has worked a full-time job and did not miss a beat. We are so happy, so proud, and I can't talk too much because I probably will start crying, but she's still gonna be here. I have another woman to love for the rest of my life, but yes, we definitely love Miss Senior DC, and we're so glad that all of you are here. What about our next Miss Senior DC and all of our contestants? Yeah. Weren't they good? Did an excellent job. They have been working so hard since May, and it shows. It shows. So we're going to be having a decision soon, but thank you again for coming, and I appreciate all that everyone has done to make this event a success. We have a great senior pageant planning committee. We have great chairs. Of course, they're all busy, otherwise I would bring them out. But I want to thank everyone who worked on this event because it was truly a labor of love. Thank you.
That's Miss Darlene Nolan. Darlene has really done a great job. You can give her another round of applause, please, for me. I tell you, man, this takes a lot of work, and Darlene is right in the middle of it and does a fantastic job. And now, it's my pleasure to present the MC Steppers who will perform their finale. So let's give them a welcome, please. Thank you.
Every woman, the MC Steppers continue the journey.
The minute you walked in the joint, I could see you were a man of distinction, real deep pockets, good looking and so fine. Wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I'll pop my coat for every guy. Time with me.
Sweeter at bus stops all his life. He's been in and out of those spaces, seeing eyes that spoke to him from
sad and empty places. Sad.
Lovely ladies worked so hard to give you just what you needed, talent, professionalism, what have you, and they've done a great, great job. So at this time, we'd like to bring the contestants back to the stage. Contestant number one, Adia Mohammed. Contestant number two, Phyllis Jordan. Contestant number three, Joycelyn Thompson. Joycelyn Thompson. Contestant number four, Paulette Cunningham. Contestant number five, Patricia Sanker. Turning now to contestant number six, Juanita Patterson. Followed by contestant number seven, Ruby Bourne. And finally, Margaret Ann Carter. Let's give them a round of applause. Always get excited when we come to this portion of the afternoon and evening, and we thank you so much once again for joining us for this pageant. It's always a great, great opportunity for me. Now we will present the award for the best interview. The ballots have been sealed, and I will announce the winner. For the best interview, Margaret Carter. Next, we will present the award for the best person with the best talent. And that winner is Margaret Carter. Next, best evening gown. Joycelyn Thompson. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, we have an award for the contestant who has sold the most tickets in advertisement combined. And so the Best Salesperson Award goes to Joycelyn Thompson. The next is Miss Congeniality, the one that all the contestants thought was the most congenial person among them all. So we're going to announce that winner at this time. Thank you, darling. Phyllis M. Jordan. Runner-up for the Miss Senior DC Pageant 2018, Joycelyn Thompson. And now we turn to the second runner-up. We'll announce it in just a few. This will be the second runner-up, Paulette Cunningham. First runner-up, Margaret Carter. It is my pleasure to present this year's Miss Senior DC, Phyllis M. Jordan.